Hi, I'm Fraser. I'm going to talk you through the Pioneer DJ integration that we've included with version 13 of Titan. Behind me here, we've just got a standard CDJ setup with a Nexus 2 CDJ and a Tour 1 CDJ. That's just networked together how you would expect and then linked out straight into the back of the Avolites Arena console. In order to get the integration working, you just need to launch the bridge software on the Arena console. You can do that from the Tools, Additional Programs menu, and launch the Pro DJ Link Bridge. You can also set the bridge to start automatically by going to the Tools, Control Panel, and Run on Startup menu. Once you've got the bridge running, you'll be able to see the CDJ shown at the bottom in green, and that's just telling you that the integration is working. The bridge handles all of the communication to the CDJs, so there's no risk of the Avolites software interfering with the DJ set. So now you've got the integration enabled, you can open the Pioneer DJ workspace from the Avolites Titan software. Straight away, you can see both of the waveforms from the CDJs that we've got connected. In this view, you can toggle on and off all of the different parts. So we can toggle off the big waveform, the small waveform, the track details, and the status bar down at the bottom there. You can also change the zoom to change how much of the track we're able to see in advance. We've got a few different layout options. We can choose to just see the master, or we can choose to see the condensed view, which is going to give you a summary of all of the connected players and the waveform of the master CDJ. The second part of the integration is the BPM sync integration. To set that up, you're just going to need to go into this system menu and set up a new trigger mapping.
So we'll just name that new mapping Pioneer. And once you've added that new mapping, you can add a trigger and change the trigger type to item. Then just select the BPM master that you would like to trigger. We can change the stimulus from master to deck 1, 2, 3 or 4, but we're just going to leave it on master and add that new trigger. You can see now that we've got that trigger added at the top there and that it's triggering the BPM into the BPM master.
So you can see that as we're changing the master, that's updating into the BPM master down at the bottom there.
I'm not gonna